Hot fudge fuckily do, Captain Hardliner! That may just be the biscuit! Well, because there's a cab driver in jolly old London town who hates my guts. I ruined his life. I didn't mean to. The guy was an asshole. Because he was one of these dickheads who starts out sentences with, I'm not a racist, but... And it's a little trick racists like to do when they want to say something racist, but they know that would be inappropriate. So they say, they're not going to say something racist. Then they say something racist. You're like, oh my God, how'd you slip that one through? You slipping a little eel. So he's driving along. He goes, I'm not a racist, but I know a doctor who says that all these bloody immigrants come to England from fuck knows where. And they don't give a shit about England or us. All they want is the free health care. And then they get fixed up and they fuck off back to wherever it is they came from in the first place. I sat in the back and I went, you're not a racist. Immigrants aren't a race. Broke his little heart. Because now he's driving going, I'm not a racist. So he had to get one in quick because he didn't know how good of a I'm not a racist butt player I am. So he goes, I'm not a racist, but Hitler was right about the Jews. And I said, the Jews aren't a race, they're a religion. Don't oo me on that. They're not a, it's not a race. You have to be circumcised. That's not a race. Black people aren't born and then painted black. No one has ever changed their race. Well, one guy did, but he's dead now. And while I'm on the subject, why did the authorities wait till after his death to investigate his doctors? Like, surely when his nose fell off, you call him in for a little questioning, like, what the fuck did you do to him? I'm not shitting you, man. It's what he wanted. But you know what authorities invested Michael Jackson's doctors over? Sleeping pills. Prescribing him sleeping pills is the least weird thing a doctor ever did to him. Like, be honest, no matter how you feel about the situation, if you were Michael Jackson's doctor and he came into your office and he went, here's the tricky thing about my life, doc. My head's falling off. Pieces of it. And everyone pretty much in the free world believes me to be a pedophile. Subsequently, I'm having a little trouble getting to sleep at night. But back to the cab. So I got this dickhead down 2-0. And I'm not a racist, but he's never been down. Because really, it's a very simple game. All you do is say you're not going to say something racist, and you say something racist. It should be as easy as racist pie. So now he's going, you got to keep it quick. He's like, I'm not a racist, but apartheid is right, and we should have it. Pretty racist, isn't it? Does anyone here know why it's not? Well, allow me to fire up the mind-blowing machine. I loosened up because I didn't want to fuck it up. I said, you're not a racist because apartheid is a Dutch word that means separate and it does not connotate black or white. Furthermore, Not only was it implemented in South Africa, it was also implemented in Liberia when freed slaves from North America were sent back to start a country there. They got their own little section of land and implemented apartheid on the locals that lived in that block of land too. So really, when you say apartheid, you're not talking about a black and white issue. You're talking about a Western culture versus African culture issue. Thank you. Yeah, don't worry, I'm right. It's been Googled and Wikipedia'd.